time of incense, part 4. A couple of weeks back, we had a series of meditation on the caption, time of incense. And we had 3 parts, and today we'll have the 4th part. Maybe you are coming to this 4th part after a small break. So I think it'll be it befitting you, me, to go through the first 3 parts, the points, very quickly. Luke chapter 1 verse 10. Luke 1 10. And the whole multitude of the people were praying without at the time of incense. At the time of incense, people are praying. Praying in the New Testament, at the time of incense in the Old Testament, almost mean one and the same. What was the shadow in the Old Testament has become the substance in the New Testament. That burning incense was a shadow in worship, worshipping the living God. It's a symbolic for the spiritual worship in the New Testament. What was a shadow in the Old Testament, it's the substance in the New Testament. So we understand the spiritual worship in the New Testament by the symbolism of the shadow that was in the Old Testament. Today we are not burning incense, we are praying. Now Luke chapter 1 verse 10. It is from the Old Testament, we are coming to the New Testament. It is on the threshold of the New Testament. And in the Old Testament, that was again the threshold of the New Testament. Malachi chapter 1 verse 11. Malachi chapter 1 verse 11. Far from the rising of the sun even unto the going down of the same, my name shall be great among the Gentiles. And in every place, incense shall be offered unto my name. Every place, incense shall be offered unto my name and a pure offering. For my name shall be great among the heathen, saith the Lord of hosts. So in every nation, every tribe, incense will be offered to my name. It has got a spiritual significance. It's not offering incense, praying in his name. It's a spiritual revelation about the church in the Old Testament. There are only very few places we get a revelation of the church in the Old Testament. This is one of the places. But it is not offering literal incense for his name in every place. It is prayer in every place. We have to lift up our hands and pray. Everywhere we can pray. So it's a revelation. Prayer in the New Testament is burning incense in the Old Testament. So I showed you from the book of Luke, from the Malachi, both these books, it is the threshold of the New Testament. The threshold of the New Testament. So about the prayer, a time of incense, a time of prayer, I wanted to bring 12 points. Number 1, prayer is a ministry. Prayer is a ministry. I love to remind you, you are telling somebody, believe in Jesus, Jesus will save you. Jesus is the Savior. He's the minister of evangelism. You pray to God, Lord, save that person. It's a ministry of prayer. Ministry of evangelism, ministry of prayer. Maybe a pastor telling his congregation, be holy. A father is telling his children, be holy. In all your behavior, be holy unto the Lord. And you pray, Lord, keep my daughter in holiness. Help my daughter walk in holiness. Not in worldliness, but godliness and holiness. You pray. There's a ministry of prayer. So we should understand In a spiritual sense, when we say prayer, prayer as a ministry. And number two, when it's a prayer as a ministry, it requires an altar. The literal meaning of that word altar is sacrifice. Sacrifice is the pedestal. Sacrifice is the altar on which we have this ministry of prayer. You want to pray for somebody. You need a sacrifice. You need time for that. You may have to sacrifice your sleep. You may have to sacrifice your TV, other pleasures. And you have to set up a time for this. To pray for others, to pray for your children, to pray for yourself also. To pray for yourself also. So it requires an altar. And number three, the place of that altar. This prayer is not outside the court of the tabernacle. It's not even in the court of the tabernacle. It is in the holy place. The ark of incense, the altar of incense, is in the holy place. So I am not talking about the prayer, a crying unto the Lord, calling upon the Lord, outside the tabernacle, even outside the fence of the tabernacle. It is inside, in the most holy place. Sorry, in the holy place. In the holy place. The ministry in the holy place is different from the ministry in the court. In the holy place, we got the table of shewbread, the candlestick on one side, in between the altar of incense. The altar of incense is just before the curtain to the most holy place. Now the curtain is removed. So the altar of incense is directly before the Ark of Covenant. To its left, there is the table with the shewbread. And to its right, it's the candlestick. The 7.5 feet tall candlestick. Just in front, the Ark of Covenant, the glory, the Shekinah glory, the mercy seat, the cherubs. So this prayer, we need the presence of God. It is in the presence of God, it's the holy place. So we must have the presence of God in prayer. Number four, it's a pleasing fragrance. In the court, it's the stink or the smell of a raw flesh burnt, the refuse of the sacrificial beast, the blood, that smell will be there. But when we come into the holy place, it is the smell of the fresh bread made out of fine wheat, fat wheat, fine wheat. With olive oil, kneaded with olive oil, fresh smell. On the other side, lamb, the candle stand with 7 lamps, with fresh olive oil, aromatic. And in front of you, the altar of incense, beautiful perfume. So the tabernacle, when you come into the tabernacle in the court, you may experience the stink of the raw flesh burnt, the stink of the raw flesh burnt. But when you come into the holy place, entirely a different scene. That's what exactly, when Jesus died on the cross, there's no beauty in him. That's very essential. He died for us on the cross. There's no beauty in him when we look at him. There's no comeliness in him. It is his visage much marred. Andhakar adindirundha. But today when he is interceding for us in the presence of God, he's like a royal high priest. royal high priest, clad in a white robe with a golden sap around his breast, his hair flowing, beautiful, the risen Savior, same Jesus. When he died as a sacrifice on the cross, there's no beauty in him. But in the holy place, as a priest, we see his beauty. So in our life also, we confess our sins, we cried, we reconciled to God, we accepted his sacrifice for us. In confessing our sins, in having our sins cleansed, there's no beauty in it. Now we come to the holy place. We come to the holy place. That's beauty in it. We have his image in us. We are doing a ministry of prayer. We are doing a ministry of prayer. So it talks about the fragrance. And number five, fire needed to bring out this fragrance. Fire needed to bring out this fragrance. These are three types of fire. One is, it's not necessary we must have this, but suffering. Or the extent we understand the suffering. Suffering, or to the extent we understand the suffering. That brings out this prayer. That brings out this prayer ministry. Love is very essential. You love your child. Every day you pray for the child. Before the child could go to school or something, you pray for the child. Every morning you pray for the child. Now the child is sick. Some fever. 101 degrees, 102 degrees. Your prayer intensity will increase. Automatically your prayer intensity will increase. Prayer, fever is 103 degrees. Your prayer will increase. More fire. More burning. It is a time of final examination. Now if the child doesn't appear for the examination, the child may be detained. A public examination. Now your prayer increases. Maybe the child is admitted to the hospital in ICU and the doctors called you and said, not much hope. Pray to your God. You can even inform your relatives. You'll hope for the best. So praying for the child daily is different from praying for the child in front of an ICU. Much different. So many a time, is it necessary that we must have suffering? No. Understand the consequence. Just imagine what will happen to the child if the child goes to hell. It's not the fever. The consequence, if the child is not saved. Think about the consequence. That will increase your prayer. Think about the safety. That will increase your prayer. So this makes the prayer burn. And the second thing, the fire of the Holy Spirit. This Holy Spirit will kindle the incense in us. The fire of the Holy Spirit. About Epaphroditus we read in the Bible. He labors in all his prayers. It's the work of the Holy Spirit. It's the work of the Holy Spirit in us to pray with tears, weeping, laboring. That prayer within us. And number three, meditation. It has got seven things on what we can meditate. It's very, very powerful. In yoga, they meditate on something, or they meditate on nothing. We are not meditating on nothing, we are not meditating on something, we are meditating on the name of God. We are meditating on God's word. We are meditating on God's power. We are meditating on God's promise. The supreme meditation, meditate on God. How great He is, His name, His attributes. I can go on and on and on. But meditation is powerful. When you meditate, there will be fire within us. There will be fire within us. That will bring out this prayer ministry more and more. Glory be to the Lord's holy name. And the number six, the timings. The timings. I said, pray in the morning, pray in the evening. There's the burning of incense. Let the prayer spirit continue all through the day. When you start for work, when you start your vehicle on the way, at the signal, when you reach your work spot, and when you start your work in the classroom or in your office, or when you have to meet your officers, and before your lunch, like that, every opportunity, let that prayer incense can come out. When you come back in the evening, burn incense. A time of incense. Have a time of prayer, an intensive prayer. Suppose you can't do it in the evening when you come back home, before you go to bed. But many a time we are tired, we are worn out. We may not be able to pray, we say a prayer. We may not be able to pray, but we will be saying a prayer. There's a much difference between saying a prayer and praying a prayer. There's much difference between saying a prayer and praying a prayer. Glory be to the Lord's holy name. And the seventh one, the forbidden things on the altar. Forbidden things on the altar. Number one, strange incense. And number two, burnt sacrifice. Number three, meat sacrifice. Number four, drink sacrifice. And we should not bring strange incense. As we should not bring strange fire, we should not bring strange incense. And we should not have these sacrifices, these to be on the outside, not in the holy place. They are in the court, the burnt offering, drink offering, meat offering. And number eight, we have to make an atonement on its horns once in a year. Why should we make an atonement? Because prayer can be misused. As we bring strange incense, we pray on wrong points. The prayers may be answered. Because the prayers are answered, it doesn't mean that you are right. It doesn't mean you are right. Many times we misunderstand. We may not know the will of God. We may not understand the word of God. We pray for wrong things. That may not be the perfect will of God. It may be our desire. And at times that would have been answered also. I can give a number of examples in the Old Testament, the New Testament. This is where people mistake, because the prayers are answered. It's only a principle. Ask and it shall be given. Ask and it shall be given. We may not know whether it's the will of God or not. Ask and it shall be given. Now, we might have asked for wrong desires. Maybe for a strife. Maybe for an argument against the will of God. Will of God to take place in our life is difficult. Something which is not the will of God, that will easily take place in our life. Everything that takes place in our life, we can't say will of God. It's very difficult for the will of God to take place in our life. Say, Balaam prayed. Once, twice, the third time, God said, go. Moses prayed, Lord, shall I send some spies, some scouts? God said yes. But those were the people who died first. And because of that, they wandered in the wilderness for 40 years. God answered Moses' prayer. But the result was horrible. The result was horrible. They could not inherit the kingdom God promised. See, when Elisha cursed, the Shebas came, killed about 42 young people. But when they spoke against Jesus, Jesus didn't pray. Jesus had prayed. All those who mocked at Jesus might have been consumed. He didn't pray. He didn't pray. In the Garden of Gethsemane, Jesus said, if I ask, that's not the will of God, but if I ask, God would send 12 legions of angels. One legion is about 6,000. 12 legions, about 72,000 angels will come if Jesus asked. But Jesus asking is not the will of God. But if Jesus asked, that prayer will be answered. That prayer will be answered. The purpose of Jesus will not be fulfilled. All the Roman soldiers might have been consumed, the story ended there. The story ended there. So without doing the will of God, we can pray and the prayers can be answered. Please, I reiterate, because the Lord answers your prayer, that is not the perfect will of God. Because it's the prayer principle. Ask and it shall be given. Whatsoever ask, you shall receive it. Whatsoever ask. Please, 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 I beg you. In many places, there's a confusion. There are erroneous teachings. I asked and God has done that. I went there, I did this, I did that. I tell you, any ministry, any church, any Christian program that doesn't show you the way of holiness and that doesn't prepare you to heaven, mostly it is false. He that is spiritual doesn't judge other things, but he discerns. But he discerns. Any prayer that doesn't fulfill the will of God in your life, even if it is answered, it is disastrous. I love to show that to you so that you can be safe. There were preachers who performed miracles. Blind might have seen, deaf might have heard, lame might have walked. The miracles were performed. So that's a prayer, answer to their prayer. As a gift operation. They might have prophesied. They might have spoken to the people about the future. Future tellers. Fortune tellers. They might have revealed the hidden secrets. They may have the gift. They may have given the gift. So all they have done in the name of Jesus. They believe in Jesus and they say, Lord, Lord, the Lord will say, I don't know you. In your name we prophesied. In your name we perform miracles. I don't know you. You evildoers, depart from me. Depart from me, you evildoers. What were they doing? Prophesy. Jesus is the evil doing. What were they doing? Performing miracles. Jesus says it's an evil doing. What were they doing? They made the blind see, the deaf hear, the lame walk. Jesus says it's an evil doing. Why? Because that was not preparing them to heaven. That was not leading them to the path of holiness. So we have to be very careful about this spiritual secret. To make this very simple, please permit me, I reiterate the illustration I gave last week. Please listen carefully and share it with others. Two boys are praying for their marriage. Both are believers, attending different churches, different types of churches. In one church, the boy was taught, ask, whatsoever ask, the Lord will give you. What all you want, you write it on a paper. Lay a hand on it. You pray. Exactly what you ask, it will be given to you. So the boy writes, I need a girl with a very fair complexion, very slim. Her hip must be of this size, other parts of the body must be of this size. He writes everything. Must be a rich girl, a girl who can buy a bike for me, a girl who can buy a car for me, a girl who can buy a fridge for me, a girl who can buy furniture for me. Everything he writes. He lays his hand. He prays. 100%. He continuously prays. Prays with faith. It's a prayer principle. He will have his prayer answered. The Lord will give him a fair looking girl, rich girl. At times the Lord gives more than what he asked. Because the promise for the wicked people. Dunmarkan avan virumbodil adhigamaya avanu kedaikirathu. It's a wicked prayer. He gets more than what he asked. He asked a girl with a bike, a girl with a car comes. There is another boy going to another church. There they taught him about the will of God. Will of God to be done in your life. So this boy also earnestly prays. Lord, let your divine will, your eternal will, that should be done in my life. I should not make a mistake. My parents should not make a mistake. And also I pray for the girl you have chosen for me. They should also yield to the will of God. She should not make a mistake. Lord, let your divine will be fulfilled in me, not my desire. Not what I have got in my mind, not my choices. Not my choices. My dear brother, my dear sister, young by 24 years old, his pastor asked, what is the condition, what type of a girl you want? That boy said, God's will. Oh, is it enough if she is the believer? He said, even that is not a condition. That pastor got a shock. Oh, no, why? He said, God told Hosea, take a war. God told Hosea, take a war. If God tells me to take a war, I'll take a war. The boy told that pastor. His desire, it's not a question whether she's a virtuous woman or a woman with vices, whether she's fair, tall, short, thin, thick, nothing. Only one desire, God's will to be done. God's will to be done. In every way, not inch after inch, not centimeter after centimeter, not millimeter after millimeter. In every way, the Lord gave a best match to him. Both the prayers are answered. Both the prayers are answered. But the other person, we can't have a guarantee whether he will have life in marriage. She's very far looking. I don't know how many will be behind her. Very rich. We don't know whether she would respect him or not. Very slim. We don't know whether she's healthy or not. His prayer is answered. And because God answered his prayers, his life became miserable. His life became miserable. Your life would be better if God has not answered your wrong prayers. You go on pester him like Balaam. First time, no. Second time, no. Third time, okay, yes. Chalta hai. Vachigapo. When God answers your prayers, the spirit will go into the pigs and the pigs will go into the sea. So we might make wrong prayers. So always we must make the atonement on the horns of the altar of incense. Horn speaks about the power. That's a power in prayer. Supernatural power in prayer. So you must know the will of God and ask the will of God to be done in your life, or you have to pray for the will of God to be done in your life. Don't fight for your desire God to do in your life. My dear brother, my dear sister, I can go on and on and on. I go to the ninth point today. I love to finish it today. We'll see how the Lord helps me. We'll go to the ninth point. We read verse 34. Please go with me to verse 34. And the Lord said unto Moses, take unto thee sweet spices. Take unto thee sweet spices. How this incense is made. What are the sweet spices in that instance? Stacte, and onycha, and galbanum. And these sweet spices with pure frankincense, of each shall thee be like weight. Of each shall there be like weight. So it's a very ordinary things. What we can get in the market is not something what we cannot get at all. Very ordinary things, I'll explain. So this incense was made of ordinary things from everyday life. So the Bible says we have treasure inside of us that lead us to His glory. So prayer ministry doesn't require a good singing. A prayer ministry doesn't require a good eloquence. A prayer ministry doesn't require a talent in music. A prayer ministry doesn't require some gimmicks. It's very simple. What we get from ordinary things. We read in 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verses 6 and 7. In this earthen vessel, God has kept His treasure. In this earthen vessel, God has kept His treasure. So what we saw is the stacte or the frankincense. It is easily available. It is easily accessible. It's not something anybody cannot buy. It's something that everybody can have an access. They are very simple things. And with that we have to make this incense. I just explain very quickly what are these four things. Stacte. In Tamil we read the word Suttamana Vellai Polam. Adha Asuttamana Vellai Polam, Suttamana Vellai Polam alla. It is a real drop. Myrrh is a very bitter one. The stacte is a green myrrh. That's the fresh one. It's a drop. Stacte, in Tamil, we read that word, Vellai Polam. Stacte means chottu, that drops. The drop that comes from the bark. A type of with more viscosity. In Tamil, if I say pisipisipisipisip, not dry, totally dried. This stacte speaks about a broken heart. For a prayer ministry, broken heart is very, very important. God who dwells in the eternal heaven, He also lives with a broken heart and a contrite spirit. So for you to do the prayer ministry, we can't just stand with arrogance in the presence of God. We need a heart that is broken. Even to pray for us. To pray for our people. We are seeking God's mercy. There are people to teach, we need not weep. We need not weep and pray. Jesus wept and prayed. Paul wept and prayed. Timothy wept and prayed. We got a lot of Bible verses. That broken heart. Please be careful about these modern teachings. They are very erroneous. You need a broken spirit. You need a broken heart. When you go to the presence of God. That is tactic. That broken spirit is very essential. And the number two is, you can make a note of it, otherwise some of you may forget. Onika. In Tamil we read the word kungaliyam. This kungilyam is made out of a shellfish, made out of shellfish. It is from the shell of that fish, shellfish. You may think that it a shellfish, a fish, it may have a type of a bad odor, not necessarily. Even some of you may like the smell of the musk, black musk, white musk, but I don't know how many of you know what musk is. Those who are using musk, if you know what musk is, you may not use musk. So it is not necessary it should be from a good smell. It is the shell of the shellfish. It is always taken from the deep waters, and it was available only in the Indian Ocean and Red Sea. That speaks about a deep life, a life that searches the depths of our heart. And the literal meaning, the root meaning of the word anika is roaring, roaring like a lion, roaring like a lion. We must go deeper and deeper, deeper in our prayer. We must understand the depth, that roaring must come. So we must have brokenness and search my inner parts, O Lord. Is there anything displeasing to you? Or what would happen to that person, the inner life, if my daughter is not saved? My son-in-law is not saved, my daughter-in-law is not saved. What will happen? That going deeper. So prayer, it is not in Tamil, I can say in the Munipul Meiradal. It's not just the Lord bless this food for me and keep his mindful for your name, say Amen. It's not that prayer. When I was in St. George's, every meal, I can hear this prayer as fast as possible, then the tangling of the plates. I do believe even now Joe will be remembering it by heart. I'm not talking about that prayer, going deep, waiting in the presence of God. And number three, staktes means a broken heart. Anika speaks about something going deep and roaring. And galbanam in Tamil, it's given as alpan pisin. It is, you have to tear a bark, we have to score a bark, and from that pierce with some sharp instrument, just make a score, as we take the gum, that way use the word pisin, it's like something like a gum. This is something very fatty, and that keeps all the other three ingredients together. When it is bounded, it makes one compound. You might have seen Sambrani Katti. How that became Katti? It is a Katti. Even you have that Kayam, Perangayam. You can have that Perangayam as a Katti, a solid one. It makes that incense a solid one. It makes the incense, all the ingredients together. It is the fatty part. The literal meaning of galbanam is giving the best. Giving the best in your prayer. And some commentators say this speaks about the very presence of God. If the presence of God is not in a prayer, the prayer is not at all, the prayer is meaningless. All the parts of prayer is brought together because of the presence of God. So brokenness is there. It's not your heart is broken in front of a statue. It's not your heart is broken in front of your mummy. It's not your heart is broken in the police station. Your heart is broken in the presence of God. You make a deep analysis of your life, not anywhere else, in the presence of God. Your petitions, your requests, your supplications, everything is made in the presence of God. So bringing the presence of God is the best in prayer. Bringing the presence of God is the best in prayer. That's the galbanam. Alban pisin. That ties everything together. Then only it becomes a katti. Sambrani katti. Perungayam katti. Kattir. Ellathin taitak. It is that alban pisin. And number four, that's very important, is pure frankincense. Pure frankincense. Frankincense, that only brings that white smoke. Sambrani. Sutta Sambrani. That brings the white smoke. When it is burnt, the smell in the stacte, it is brought out and it ascends, it fills the whole place. It is because of the frankincense. Sambrani. Sambrani poha. When all these perfumes are added, even that Sambrani has got a perfume in it. When all these perfumes are added, that Sambrani brings out a good smell. You know, those who have come from Hindu background, some Christian, those who use this incense, you know, there is some Sambrani called Matta Sambrani. Matta Sambrani means Mattamana Sambrani. Mattamana Sambrani, that will bring only smoke, that may not bring perfume. But a Vasatyana Sambrani, costly Sambrani, the real Sambrani, very soft, it will be solid but very soft, that will bring that white fumes, more fire, just fan it, goop, that white fumes will come, white smoke will come. Beautiful, I love that smell, I love that smoke. So that frankincense, when it touches the fire, it makes that smoke ascend to heaven. It brings out that smoke. That speaks about faith. Without faith, you pray with a broken heart. You pray with a deep searching. You pray in the presence of God. And you don't have faith, no use of your prayer. Your prayer cannot ascend. Your prayer cannot go up. How can your prayer go up? Only when there is faith. So these are the four components the incense was made. So for prayer, you need four components. Broken heart, a deep search, presence of God, faith, pure faith, unfeigned faith, maya matra visuvasa. Even faith to the size of a mustard seed is enough, but that should be unfeigned faith. With that, the prayer ascends into heaven. In the New Testament, I got a number of verses. I just give you the verses, you make a note of it. 1 Timothy chapter 2, verses 1 and 2. Philippians chapter 4, verse 6. Ephesians 6, 18. Ephesians 6, 18. In the New Testament, you need these four things in prayer. Number one, that worship. Praise, the worthiship, that brings the presence of God. Feeling how great God is. It's not, as I said, I'm not teasing, but I mean, it's not saying stotram, 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 stotram. It's not that stotram. It's born out of your meditation because of that heat. How great the word. How great the word. வானத்தின் பூமி உண்டாக்கினவரே உமக்கு ஸ்தோத்திரம் ஐயா. சர்வ வல்லமுள்ள தேவனே உமக்கு ஸ்தோத்திரம். That's prayer, that's praise. Worship, worthyship. Worship is not singing, worship is not dancing, worship is not jumping. Worship is paying worthyship to Him. That's what we say in Tamil, Aradhana. Aradhana. Singing is only bhajan. Singing is bhajan. Bhajan is good. Bhajan must help Aradhana. Aradhana is giving the worthyship to Him. More fire. More you meditate on Him. Go deeper. How great He is. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He will lead me in the path of righteousness for His name's sake. Yes, it's true, I walk through the valley of the shadow of death. I fear no evil because the Lord is with me. His staff, His rod will comfort me, strengthen me. He will surely set a table for me in the presence of my enemies. He will fill my cup with His blessings. He will make my cup run over. He anoints my head with oil. Meditate on this. Praise Him, what God can do for you. So praising. Praising is not sotram. It is worship, worthyship. Number two, intercession. Intercession, the Greek word means asking someone's favor on behalf of a third person. Asking someone's favor because of a third person. That's the intercession. You are in between. So you are praying for somebody, you are praying for your wife, you are praying for your daughter, you are praying for your friend. Everything is intercession. Parindurai. Parindurai-tal. Aradhital. Parindurai-tal. In your dhubam, in your incense, there should be worship, there should be intercession. And number three, petitions. Asking God for your needs. He knows that you need all these things. Ask and it shall be given. It's His condition. The bank has got money to give the education loan. But you have to ask for it. You have to give the petition. You have to give the application. You must fulfill the required demands. So number three, petition. Ask for the Lord for your daily bread. Ask for a good house. Ask for a good ministry. Ask for God's will to be done in your life. It is for your personal need. You are not asking for your wife. You are not asking for your husband. You are not asking for your friend. You are not asking for a sinner. Many a time we think intercession is asking for somebody else. Abraham interceded for Lot. His own nephew. He interceded. So intercession is to talking to God for His favor on behalf of a third person. Petition, giving to the Lord your demands, your needs. And that shows humility. Unless He does this for me, I can't get it. Call unto Him. He will show you things what you cannot reach. In a noki kupudu. Appodhu unni gettada periya kari. I can't get it. That shows humility. And number four, thanksgiving. Probably that was number two, thanksgiving. Praises and thanksgiving, two different things. You are thanking, praising God for what He is. You are thanking God for what He has done for you. You are thanking God for what He has done for you. The other day, a very small thing, very thought-provoking. A gentleman in his 70s. When he was talking to us, he just said about the answering calls normally. Answering calls normally. He said, வேற ஒண்ணுக்கும் வேணாங்க, காலையில் நார்மலாக இருக்குது. 70 வருஷமாக இந்த இன்டஸ்டைன்ஸ், த பவல்ஸ், சாஃப்ட் டிஷ்யூஸ் நார்மலாக ஒர்க் பண்ணுதுன்னு அர்த்தங்க. நார்மலாக ஒர்க் பண்ணுதுன்னு அர்த்தம். 70 வருஷமாக அது நார்மலாக ஒர்க் பண்ணுது. அதனால தான் இன்னைக்கு உங்கள் இயற்கை உபாதையை நீங்கள் நார்மலாக சேருங்க. A very simple statement that made me think deeper. It's all because of him. It's all because of him. We are what we are today. You are what we are today. It's all because of him. Think about it. Thank him. So praising is for what he is and thanking him for what he has done. What he has done. Think about it. Nandi endru sollugiran nada. Indha uliyathai ivvalavu nadathittu vandhaare. Thank you, Lord. A situation came that many left. One, it's a small, it's a beginning stage. 35 families left the church. Whatever the cost may be. I was clinging to the Lord. One man prophesied, oh, cream of the church left. That's all, cream of the church left. Not with arrogance, with all humility. Cream of the church left. Jesus didn't leave me. Jesus didn't leave me. Not their tidings. Not their help, influence, their assistance, whatever. In every way I love them, in every way I respect them, in every way I thank God for their contribution. But when all those things became minus, God with me, nothing we lacked. Nothing we lacked. We didn't go into debts. My dear brother, my dear sister. The only one sad thing in that, we lost some good believers. Again, it's a very sad thing. Some of them lost a good church. Some of them may be in a better church. My dear brother, my dear sister, thank God for what he has done for you. So prayer must have, in the Old Testament we saw, that's essential for prayer, brokenness, feeling the presence of God, faith, pondering deeper, all this make the prayer. In prayer, in the New Testament we see worship, thanksgiving, what's the third one? Intercession, supplication, or petition. This makes our prayer. Glory be to the Lord's holy name. I can go on and on and on. I got two more points. I finish it quick. Now the tenth one, take all these things in equal measure. Now, brokenness, totally broken. And your prayer cannot be only brokenness. Your prayer can't be only weeping. Your prayer must have roaring also. Only not that stacte, your prayer must have that onika also. It is not only vellaipolam, it must have that kungaliyam. It is not only kungaliyam, hallelujah, praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise the Lord, it's not roaring. You must have brokenness. And the presence of God is not dumping and dancing. That alban pisin, that gum is very essential. And in all those things, without faith, nothing can go up. I got strong faith, though no brokenness. விசுவாசிக்கிற நயப்படியே ஆளுவேன், கர்த்தர் செய்வார்னு விசுவாசிக்கிற ஸ்தோத்திரம். நோ, யூ மஸ்ட் ஹவ் அ கான்ட்ரைட் ஸ்பிரிட். பட் தட் கான்ட்ரைட் ஸ்பிரிட் ஷுட் நாட் லீட் டு அன்பிலீஃப். So you must have all these four in equal measure. With that, you must have worship. You can't spend the whole time worship. You have to intercede for others. You have to pray for your wife, your husband, your children, your neighbor, your friends. Even you have to pray for your enemies. You have to pray for those who hurt you. So you have to intercede. You have to thank God for what He has done for you. And you have to give petitions, what you require. What you require. All these things must be in equal measure. Okay? Now, I must have equal measure in this point so that we can conclude. Number 11, mixing it a perfume. Mixing it a pure katti, a solid one. Like any other perfumer will do it. Because we are adding this onika and all, it is easy to get spoiled. And the myrrh, stacte, that's also tender one, the stage of that pisipisipis. So what he suggests when you make it, in verse 35, and thou shalt make it a perfume, a confection, after the art of the apothecary, tempered together, pure and holy. That word tempered is nothing but salted. You add salt to it. Salt is very essential because the onyx, stacte, and galbanum also. Easy to get, decayed. Very tender one. So we had to add salt to it. The tempered, literally meaning salted. The Greek, Hebrew word is salted. That salt speaks about holy life. Purity. One of the meanings of the word temper is purity. I read in one book, an amount of salt can affect anything that is 1,000 times more than the amount of a salt. See, 1 gram salt, 1 gram salt is enough for 1,000 gram of anything, fish or pickle or anything. 1,000 times. I don't know how many, I don't know about the equation, but I read in one book. It can affect, maybe the preservation, I don't know, you may be knowing better. There's an information I read in a book. Any amount of salt that can influence 1,000 times more quantity of the articles. So when you take all these things in equal measure, that salt is very essential. Your brokenness without holiness. Your deep pondering without holiness. Your faith without holiness is not going to work out. Holy life is very, very important. The prayer of the wicked is abomination to God. The prayer of the wicked is an abomination to God. Many years back, some 30, 40 years back, what I preached in one all-night prayer, that pastor was talking to me, maybe about some 30 years back. He was talking to me, he said, Pastor, I still remember that. You know what that I said? In an all-night prayer, in a prayer, a group prayer, there is a person who speaks lie. There's a person who speaks like poi pesara orthan irukran and the jaba valila and the poi pesara appa pidave appdinu koopidran yaarunga varuva sollunga pisasa dhaan varu yen avan poi ki pida avan poi pesaraven pidave appdinu koopta yaar dhaan varum pisasa dhaan varu illana bible thappa padu poi pesaraven pidave nu koopta yesu varamattar without holiness. Without that salt, Your prayer is not only meaningless, your prayer would become demonic. Your prayer would become demonic. Pray, devils can also pray. So holiness is very, very important. Otherwise, your own, I mean, I don't have time to explain, your own brokenness will lead you to pride. Your own deep, the deep will lead you to pride. Unless you are holy unto the Lord. And when you are mixing that with holiness, the 12th point, the Bible says in verse 36, and thou shalt beat some of it very small and put it before the testimony in the tabernacle of the congregation where I will meet with thee. It shall be unto you most holy. So I made one big bar. I made a big bar. But the real incense, I just break something into it. I break it into powder. I keep it in the very presence of God. I use it in the fire. That is the most holy one. That is the prayer. You may have so many requests. You may have so many friends. In every prayer, you cannot pray for everybody. I know an uncle. Whosoever he would meet, he would say, "Nee ungalukaga pray panna." Really, it's $1 million miracle. How could he pray for 1,000 people? Even if it takes half a minute, he needs 500 minutes. How could he pray for 1,000 people? The best thing, there are two alternatives. Alternative number one, he must be bluffing. My uncle doesn't bluff, he's a nice uncle. Alternative number two, in the morning he must have said, "Andavare enakku therinja ellarum aashirvadi." So whosoever he would meet, he would say, "I prayed for you. I pray," because he has prayed. Illa letters varum. Chela evangelists all gimmicks. They keep all the letters together. They keep their hand. "Lord, the petitions ellam umakku theriyum. Neer aashirvadi andavare." Then they write a reply. "We prayed for your prayer request." I don't know. Whether God is cheated, or they cheat themselves, or those who send the letters are cheated. Somewhere something is happening. My dear brother, my dear sister. One person was fed up of prayer. So he made his prayer shorter and shorter. And every day almost is the same prayer. "Lord, bless my father, bless my mother, bless my wife, bless my children. Lord, I commit my life into your hand this night. Protect me, save, help me see a good morning," etc. It's the same prayer. Every day almost he prayed the same. Then his wisdom was done. He wrote all that prayer. He said, "Lord, you know what I want to pray. Bless this prayer, Lord." Every day he would lay his hand on the sheet. "Bless this prayer, O Lord." God knows. God knows what I'll return in that. My dear brother, my dear sister, don't learn this also. Prayer is a wonderful thing. It's a time of incense when they are showing incense. At the time of incense, the multitude was praying. May the Lord increase our prayer life. Shall we just stand to our feet for a minute? Feel the presence of God close by your side. Those who really desire, I desire, those who really desire this type of a prayer gift, you need this prayer gift. Slip your hand up wherever you are. We'll ask God. Hallelujah. This prayer gift, I want it. I need this prayer gift. Slip your hand towards the Lord. Hallelujah, I pray for you. I pray for myself also. Dear Father God, we thank you, we praise you, Lord. For past 4 weeks, O Lord, 4 Sundays, we are meditating on this prayer. Let not be just a meditation or an academic information, O Lord. Lord, give me this spirit of prayer. Give me this gift of prayer, O Lord. Let it influence my prayer life, O Lord. I have spoken to your dear people, O Lord. Right now, with all humility in your name, I pray for these dear ones. Give them the gift of prayer, Lord. the ministry of prayer, O Lord. The components of prayer, the ingredients of prayer, O Lord. The meaning, the purpose, the pleasure of prayer, O Lord. In all its totality. Command this prayer life in them, O Lord. Help your people receive this prayer life. We praise you, we thank you, we worship. Those who believe that the Lord gives you the gift that you ask for, raise up your hands and worship him. Thank him. Thank him that you believe that he has given you this gift. It's not because of an emotional sign, but in faith, receive it. When you receive this, start using it from today. We thank you. We praise you, we worship you. In Jesus' matchless name, we pray. Amen.